understand that we approach your throne of grace, realizing full well that we are not fit to come into your presence.
Yes, yes.
But because of Jesus, because of the precious Lamb of God, you provided for us entree into your presence. Now, Lord, as we gather together here, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, thy reward, my strength, and my reward.
Because you dwell in the secret place of the Most High.
So I come to tell somebody this morning, when you dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you don't need to be afraid. I come to tell you that trials may be pressing you on every hand and trouble may be everywhere, but don't be afraid, because it will not come near you. So stand erect, hold your head up high, pull your shoulders back, poke your chest out, and say like the songwriter said, I feel like pressing on.
Yeah.
Now this can be a good and effective word for people in this room. This can be a good and effective word for someone who needs to keep pushing forward under pressure. Because we live in a time of constant pressure. Am I right about it? Anybody that got a job, you know that you live in times of constant pressure. If you got a family, you know that there's constant pressure. There's always an adversary to confront and a challenge that you have to face. Life is not always easy, because it's filled with disappointments and changes. I said, and changes.
Yeah.
I said, and changes.
Yeah.
But you can't stop living because you're disappointed. You cannot stop living because things have changed. How many people in here have figured out that somehow you just got to keep on going? That you can't stop in the face of issues. You have to keep on going. You can't allow yourself to be hindered or deterred when crises come, because crises are going to come. But what you have to do in the face of a crisis is keep on going. Money is funny, keep going. Friends are few, keep going. Misunderstood, keep going. Loss of a loved one, keep going. Plan don't work out, keep going. I preached a sermon one time entitled, Don't Stop in Hell. Anybody remember that sermon? Don't Stop in Hell. The premise of that sermon was, you can't give up and quit and stop in the face of adversity. You can't stop when it looks like everything is against you. But instead, you keep pressing on, up on the upward way. Whether you know it or not, you have to put on the whole armor of God every day.
Amen.
Oh, yes, you do. You got to put it on every day, because the pressure is constant. You need the helmet of salvation and the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet need to be shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, so that you might be able to stand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. You have to stand, therefore, with your loins girded about with truth. You have to stand sober-minded, ready to confront the issues of your day and the issues of your time. You can slow around and think that you don't if you want to. You can get behind not doing anything. Because the world is constantly moving. And if you're standing still and the world is moving, you don't have to do anything to get behind. So you have to be sober-minded and vigilant to confront the issues of your day and time. Now before I get too deep in that, I need to tell you something about this text. Will it be all right if we talk about the text a little bit? This text is meant for a special type of person. Just anybody can't fool around with this text, because this text won't work for everybody. This text is written for he. If you look in the King James Version, it starts out that he that doeth. Now I know what you're saying. Who is he? Well, let me tell you who the he is. He is the one who dwells in the secret place of the Most High. You see, if you're not going to dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you need to be afraid. I'm going to say that again. If you're not going to dwell in the secret place of the Most High, you need to be afraid. And what do you need to be afraid of? You need to be afraid of the snare of the fowler. You need to be afraid of the pestilence. You need to be afraid of the arrows. And you need to be afraid of the night terrors and the night tremors. You don't need to be afraid. because you don't have to worry because they're coming. They are coming, and you need to be afraid if you're not dwelling in the secret place of the Most High. The writer says, he that dwells in the secret place of the Almighty shall abide. Shall abide quick. Now he just stopped that thing right there. Shall abide. Well, where shall we abide? Shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Well, who is this Almighty whose shadow that I'm going to stand under? David said, he is my refuge. He said, he's my hiding place. He's the place where I go and hide out. Let me see if I can do it better than that. He's my fallout shelter. Anybody know anything about a fallout shelter? Young folk don't know anything about a fallout shelter. The fallout shelter is a throwback to the 60s and 70s when the Cold War was going on and Cold War was raging. Back then, there was a constant threat that Russia was going to drop an atomic bomb on us. So there were these fallout shelters that were strategically placed around most of the major cities. The fallout shelter was a place of refuge. It was a place, a safe place for people to go for the protection of the effects of the atom bomb. Not only does David say he is my refuge, David also says he's my fortress. Now, there's a difference between a refuge and a fortress. A refuge is a place where you go to hide out, but a fortress is defense against attack. Y'all ain't getting it. So that means that God doesn't just keep us safe, but he fortifies us and builds us up. He's our defense mechanism. Whether that defense is against a foreign enemy or an attack on your mind, whether that defense is against an attack against your body, or whether it's an attack against your finances, the Lord is my fortress and he is my refuge. He is my secret weapon. Somebody say, I got a secret weapon. He is where I go when my heart is overwhelmed. That's how I deal with my day.